I was born in a Dublin street where the royal drums do beat, and the loving English feet, they tramped all over us. And each and every night, when me father'd come home tight, he'd invite the neighbours outside with this chorus. Oh, come out, you black and tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilashandra. Come, let me hear you tell how you slammed the brave Parnell when you thought him well and truly persecuted. Where are the sneers and jeers that you bravely let us hear when our heroes of 16 were executed? Ah, come out, you black and tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilashandra. Come tell us how you slew them poor Arabs 2 by 2, like the Zulus they had spears and bows and arrows. How you bravely faced each one with your 16-pounder gun, and you frightened them poor natives to their marrow. Ah, come out, you black and tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilashandra. The day is coming fast, and the time is here at last, when each yawning will be cast aside before us. And if there be a need, sure my kids will sing Godspeed with a verse or two of Stephen Bean's chorus. Ah, come out, you black and tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilashandra.
I dreamed I saw Joe Hill last night, alive as you and me. Said I, but Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he. From Salt Lake City, Joe, said I, him standing by my side. They framed you on a murder charge, says Joe, I never died. Said Joe, I never died. The copper bosses shot you, Joe. They filled you full of lead. Takes more than guns to kill a man, says Joe, and I ain't dead. Said Joe, and I ain't dead. And standing there as big as life, him smiling with his eyes, said he what they forgot to kill, went on to organize, went on to organize. From San Diego up to Maine, in every mine and mill, where working men defend their rights. It's there you'll find Joe Hill. It's there you'll find Joe Hill.
Spent many an hour with Kitty and Judy and Mary. Me father rebuked me for being such a rake, for spending me time in such frolicsome ways. But I ne'er can forget the good nature of Jane, of his father me should not a shame. If I chance for to go to the town of Rathkeel, all the girls all around me do flock on the square, and some give me buttons and other sweet cake to treat me unknown to their parents. There's one from Maskeaton and one from the Pike, another from Arden, me heart is beguiled, and being from the mountains, her stockings are white, of his father me soon not at all shame. I ne'er was inclined, for the greatest of misers must leave them behind. I'll buy me a cow that will never run dry, and I'll milk her by twisting her horns. John Damer of Shoal had plenty of gold, Lord Devonshire's treasures was 20 times more, but they laid up their backs among nettles and stones, of his father me sued not at all shame. Some say I'm foolish and more say I'm wise, to be fond of the women I think it's no crime. The son of King David had 10,000 wives, and his wisdom was highly regarded. I'll till a good garden and live at me ease, each woman and child can partake of the same. If there's more in the camp, sure themselves they can blame, of his father me sued not at all shame. And now for the future I mean to be wise, and I'd send for the women who acted so kind. I'll marry them all in the long by and by, if the clergy agrees to the bargain. I'm on me back and me soul is at peace, the women will crowd for to cry at me wake, and their sons and their daughters will offer a prayer to the Lord for the soul of their father. With me hidin' dee hidin' dee hidin' dee hey, skither yodlum fall the doodlum no wet all the day, diddly yodlum dee dan dee didledum day, of a smog me sued more at
Peggy Gordon, you are my darling. Come sit you down upon my knee and tell to me the very reason why I am slighted so by thee. I'm so deep in love, and I can't deny it. My heart lies smothered in my breast. It's not for you to let the whole world know. troubled mind can know no rest. I put my head to a cask of brandy. It was my fancy, I do declare, for when I'm drinking, I am always thinking and wishing Peggy Gordon was there. I wish I was in some lonesome valley where womankind cannot be found. Small birds, they all change their voices, and every moan sounds. I wish I was away in England, or out across the briny sea, or sailing on the deepest ocean, where want and care can trouble me. Peggy Gordon, you are my darling. Come sit you down upon my knee and tell to me the very reason why I am slighted so by thee.
Sublar, Sublar. And from the plains of Royal Meath, strong men came hurrying through, while Britannia's sons with their long-range guns sailed in by the foggy dew. But the bravest bell and the solemn bell rang more. Shine through the foggy dew. nations might be free. But their lonely graves are by Sublis Wade on the fringe of the grey North Sea. Oh, have they died by Pierce's side, or fought with Calibrew? Their names we would keep where the Fenians sleep, beat the shroud of the Foggy Dew. Right to the glen I rode again, my heart with grief was sore.
Fine old woman, long time ago, this proud old woman did say, I had four green fields, each one was a jewel. Then strangers came and tried to take them from me. I had fine, strong sons. They fought to save my jewels. They fought and died, and that was their grief, said she. Long time ago, said this fine old woman. Long time ago, this proud old woman did say, there was war and death, plundering and pillage, my children starved on mountain, valley and sea. For green fields ran red with their blood, said she. What have I now, said the proud old woman. What have I now? This proud old woman did say, I have four green fields, and one of them's in bondage. nature's hands that's tried to take it from me. But my sons have sons as brave as were their fathers. My four green fields will bloom once again, said she.
I read of ancient free men from Greece and Rome who bravely stood, 300 men and free men. And then I prayed I yet might see our fetters rent in twain and Ireland long a province be a nation once again, a nation once again, a nation once again, and Ireland long a province be a nation once again. And from that time through wildest woe, that hope has shone a far light. Their woodlands bright as summer glow outshone that solemn starlight. It seemed to watch above my head in forum, field and fane. Its angel's voice sang round my bed, a nation once again, a nation once again, and Ireland long a province be a nation once again. It whispered to that freedom's ark and service high and holy would be profaned by feelings dark and passions vain or lowly. For freedom comes from God's right hand and needs a godly train, and righteous men must make our land a nation once again. A nation once again, a nation once again, and Ireland long a province be a nation once again. So as I grew from boy to man, I bent me to that bidding. My spirit of a selfish plan and cruel passion ridding. For thus I hope someday to wait, or can such hope be vain, when my dear country will be made a nation once again. A nation once again, a nation once again, and Ireland long a province be a nation once again.
One evening fair, to take the air down by Blackwater Side, and in gazing all around me, an Irish lass I spied, all in the fore part of the night. We sat in sport and play, when this young man arose and gathered his clothes, saying, fare thee well today. That's not the promise you made to me as you lay upon my breast. You could make me believe with your lying tongue that the sun rose in the west. Go home, father's garden, go home and cry your fill. Go think on the sad misfortune you brought on with your wanton. There's not a flower in this whole world as easily led as I. And when fishes can fly and the seas they run dry, it is then you will marry I. Early in the morning, the silver's in the stubble, and it wasn't there before. And the leaves, they're getting greener, and spring is on the way, and girls are getting prettier and younger. To go to
church on Sundays, hark, I hear the bell. But the leaves, they're getting greener, and spring is on the way, and girls are getting prettier and younger. If any girl will have me, she'll only have to say, I'll hang my halo on a hook until another day. For the leaves, they're getting greener, and spring is on. Prettier and younger every day.
What's the news? What's the news? Oh, my bold chevalier, with your long barrel gun on the sea. Say what winds from the south blows its messenger here, with the hymn of the dawn for the free. Goodly news, do I bring you the forth? Goodly news, do I hear, bargeman? For the boys march at dawn from the south to the north, led by Kelly, the boy from Kilane. Tell me who is that giant with the gold curling hair, he who rides at the head of your band. 7 feet is his height with some inches to spare, and he looks like a king in command. Army boys, that's the pride of the bold Shelmaliers, amongst our bravest of heroes a man. Fling your beavers aloft and give 3 ringing cheers for John Kelly, the boy from Kilane. Enniscorth is in flames and old Wexford is won, and tomorrow the Barrow we cross. On the hill or the town they have planted a gun that will batter the gateway to Ross. All the fort men and bargemen will march o'er the heath, with brave Harvey to lead on the van. But the foremost of all in that grim gap of death will be Kelly, the boy from Kilane. But the gold sun of freedom grew darkened at Ross, and it set by the slain his red wings. And poor Wexford stripped naked hung high on a cross, and her heart pierced by traitors and slaves. Glory oh, to those brave sons who died for the cause of long downtrodden man. Glory oh, to Mount Leinster's own darling and pride, dauntless Kelly, the boy from Kilane.
If my health is spared, I'll be long relating of a boat that sailed out from Annerchuain, and the keening after of mother and father, as the laying out of each corpse was done. O King of graces, who died to save us, 'twas a small affair, but for one or two
when a boat load bravely on a calm day sailing without wind or rain to be swept to doom. The boat sprang a leak and left all those people and frightened sheep adrift on the tide. It beats all telling what fate befell them. 11 strong men and 8 women to die. Men who could manage a plow and harrow to break a furrow or scatter seed, and women whose fingers were deft and nimble to spin white linen or cloth to weave. Young lads were lying when crops were ripening. From the strength of youth they were laid to clay in their wedding clothes. For their wakes they robed them. O King of Glory, man's hope in vain. May burning mountains come tumbling down on that place of drowning. May curses fall for many a sad heart is filled with mourning and left alas one a bright day's dawn. The cause of their fate was no fault of sailing, 'twas the boat that failed them near Caslon Rua and left me to wake with a heart that's breaking this lamentation of Annerchuain. I've never been out of Salford Town since the day that I was born, except when I was in the ranks and wore a uniform. But I'd sooner never travel if the only way to see the world was through the battle sights of a Mark 303. I wish that I could see the world, the north, south, east, and west. I'd like to travel everywhere with the girl that I love best. But I'll stand beside the Irwell all my life before I'll stand in some foreign country with a bayonet in my hand. I have a little baby, he's the apple of my eye. When I think about his future, my thoughts
take wings and fly. What kind of future can he have with planes and tanks and guns, when flying high and dropping bombs on other people's sons? I work upon the docks each day and watch the ships come in, where no one asks to see the color of a sailor's skin. Side by side we're working men from Norway, China, Greece. Why can't the statesmen do the same and let us live in peace?